Yes, the last speaker is Chris Carrico. Hi.
Hi.
Nice to see you all again. I'm Chris Carrico in Encinitas, and I'd like to talk on propositions F and G. And I'd like to talk on behalf of those who oppose the TOT tax. I just would like to go on record to clarify some perceptions about the vacation rentals and the hotels and motels. I went online today to find out how many hotels and motels were in Encinitas, and I found about 8 of them. And they pay approximately a little under $325,000 in property tax. The vacation rentals, there's approximately 123 of those, and they pay just short of $1 million. So we pay about 3 times more in property taxes than the hotels and motels. According to the argument in favor of Proposition F, it stated that it helps to pay for the services such as sheriffs, fire, lifeguard, etc., and also they do not pay for the support, that the vacation rentals do not pay for the support of the local services they use. And I beg to differ with that, because we actually do pay it in our property taxes of the $1 million that we're paying. And a lot of the owners of these vacation rentals don't live in Encinitas, so they can't vote. So they're being taxed on something that they can't even vote for. And that's kind of a situation that really is a taxation without representation. Also, we're being taxed $150 for a fee every year. Hotels and motels, they pay a $15 renewal business license fee. So there's quite a bit of difference there. And the enforcement is going to be an issue, because there's so many different owners. And the hotel and motels, they have 402 rooms. In the vacation rentals, there's about 123 of the units. So there's quite a bit of difference between the hotels and motels. And the vacation rentals do bring a lot of business to the city of Encinitas, and they do pay for the services. And so we do pay our share. And also, we feel at this time that the vacation rentals are being taxed twice. And we also would like to urge a no vote on Propositions F and G.